Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Joren, or Triplus as I like to make myself known online. And today I have another video for you. This video idea actually got triggered by some questions I've had regarding to this launch pad or landing page or whatever you want to call it that I'm using in, that you can see in a lot of my videos. I actually started using this tool when I was having trouble keeping track of all my different applications that I had after like starting a VMware system, a Docker system, and so on. And I was having a really tough time keeping track of all the ports, all the host names, and so on of all my different applications. And I went searching for a solution and I came across two tools. One of them was called Heimdall, one of them was called Organizer. I tried both, but I did settle on Organizer in the end, which is what you see here right now, and also in a lot of my videos. So looking at the Organizer homepage, as you can see here, the tooling describes itself as it aims to be your one-stop shop for your server's frontend. And this is exactly what I'm using it for. As you can see, I have an easy way from switching to, for example, my Home Assistant, to my Nagios system. And then as you can see, I have quite a few other applications there. And I did take a quick liking to the fact that Organizer is compatible with Nginx, or still not sure how to pronounce it, but the reverse proxy tooling that I'm using on some other parts of my home lab and my overall network topology, let's say. And the goal that I have with this server and the exact question that I've gotten is, what is Jump? So Jump is just a name I've given myself, but this is my one server that is accessible on my VPN, and I reverse proxy all my other applications through this specific server, so that my VPN, first you would need access to my VPN if you want to connect to this, but also only this application or this server is accessible on my VPN, so it adds an additional layer of security on my VPN network and my overall network connectivity. Next to this whole reverse proxying and landing page application engine, Organizer also supports some kind of widgets. I'm not sure if it's on the homepage actually, I haven't looked into that. Right, it's a bit here, but basically those widgets are some additional tooling that you can show to display certain things like last downloaded. It's actually here. So here indeed you can see like recently added content for your Jellyfin, your MB, your Plex system, whatever. So it's a bit of an additional homepage, but I prefer to use Home Assistant for that. And as you can see here, I do have some way of tracking also those kind of things. So I don't have a lot of experience with the widgets, but I do have quite the experience with the reverse proxying and the what I call launchpad approach for Organizer. So of course, like most applications these days, there are a few ways of installing Organizer. I am using, in my opinion, the easiest approach, which is Docker. It's just a simple container that I just need to update from time to time, and everything gets updated, and I don't need to take care of any of the dependencies and so on. Which is also like fun fact, there actually is a new version available, as you can see here, and here it states that there's a minimum PHP version unless you're running in a container, so makes my life easier. So maybe a quick run through of some of the features that Organizer has. So of course we have the tabs, which is the list that you see here on the left. As you can see, there are different types like iframe or new window. Iframe is what you see here, so it just loads with the sidebar still intact. There are some applications, for example, Pi-hole is one of them, that are by default not supported in an iframe. I know there are workarounds for that, but I just didn't want to make my life too difficult. So for some of them, as you can see in the settings, so Pi-hole opens in a new window. And then of course you have the, where is it? I did see it earlier. So the organizer type, which is basically the menu setting that you see here. So that's the top categories, again, that's a bit your grouping. And then you have the homepage items, which again, I'm not that familiar with, but it seems quite straightforward, just setting it up and going from there. And then an order, like, as you can see, I did play a bit around with it, but not too much. Of course, there's a whole customization thing where, like, you can change colors, icons, CSS, JavaScript, whatever. There's a small marketplace with icons. User management, as I explained earlier, there's also a login aspect to this. I'm not going to click this because there are email addresses in here from myself and my girlfriend. But it just makes it easy to also give different options to different people. For example, this whole management thing my girlfriend doesn't have access to. Not because she cannot, but because she has no interest. Same with Narios. She does, however, have access to some of these media things, for example. So it is useful to have that. And the rest is much less important. Maybe another useful thing, there is a way of single sign-on, for example, with Jellyfin, with Plex. So it has a lot of features, the exact amount of features, again, you can find on the website, in the GitHub repository. So it is quite a good tool, in my opinion, to go there. Of course, one important thing, if looking at the tops, for example, as you can see here, my Home Assistant, the URL is again routing through my Jump server, which again, as I mentioned, the only server accessible on my home net or on my VPN. So I have reverse proxy every single service that I want accessible on my VPN. I have reverse proxied through Nginx. And this is one of those examples. So as you can see, for example, I have, I'm going to try to find a good example. This is, well, organizing itself, of course, is reverse proxied. But yeah, take a look at this. So we have this URL here. So this is my pi-hole, or one of my pi-hole instances, so dns1.triplusnet.home. However, if I want to access this from outside my network, I need to reverse proxy this. Clicking this, you see I am in fact going to dns1.jump.triplusnet.home. And I also have an SSL certificate here. So my jump server is basically the reverse proxy for everything. It's a bit of a custom setup, and also, like, in Organizer, by default of Nginx, I did put another layer in front of it for my home-related reasonings to make things a bit more easy to manage. But like, this approach is very well feasible in the standard Nginx tooling within Organizer itself. And as you can see here, also you have an ART request. This means what I mentioned earlier is that you have different account levels or permission levels, meaning that, like, ART 0, I think everybody can access, but for example, ART 3, not everybody can access. So you have like this admin, super admin, I don't know the exact namings anymore, but so there is some degree of user management and so on. So what you could do is, for example, give guests access to your media server, streaming server, whatever, but not give them access to, for example, Home Assistant. So there's a whole layer of that in there. So again, to maybe explain my setup in a bit more detail. So I have my jump server, which is called jump.triplusnet.home. From there, this server is running Nginx only, and every single thing is being reverse proxied through there. So the root domain, as you can see, is going to Docker. On this port, we have we have Organizer running. As you can see, I'm not fully logged in because of certain reasons with HTTPS and so on, but whatever. From there, I have all these different server blocks. So Portainer is running on port. So this is the jump URL of my Portainer instance, pointing to this with a certain authentication aspect to it. And some services require additional URLs to be forwarded and so on, but Like, this is how every of my services is reverse proxied, so it is accessible on my jump server. And then in my organizer, I basically just punch in all these reverse proxied things, as you can see. So portainer.jump.tripplesnet.home, DNS1.jump.tripplesnet.home, DNS2.jump.tripplesnet.home. I don't have all my instances or all my applications reverse proxied, but it could be done. And that is the strength, in my opinion, of this, again, jumping application. So this is really the reason why I call this jump, and it sounds stupid, is that it makes, or at least for me, it jumps from one application to the other, and it is my jump into my own network from the outside. In my opinion, things also are relatively secure this way, because you do need a login to access all these different applications and services that I have running. Again, the application is only as secure as the people who've written it made it. However, it's open source, so if you find anything, feel free to help the guy out. He has been pushing a lot of updates, so I am really enjoying that. And basically that's it. I hope this video does explain a bit of what Organizer is, what is launched, what is it I have, and how I'm using it, and how you can also make it your own. Some people, like from what I've read, just use it as an internal tool and only have for example, docker dot whatever, so docker.home and then the port in their tops. It's also fully possible. I have a bit of a complexer system with my own DNS server running, that because of that I have my own internal host names and so on. So you can go as simple or as complex as you want. This was like, I found it fun to set this up. It's part of my hobby, but it's also very useful, because I can go to my parents, I go to jump, like I start up my VPN, I go to jump.tripplesnet.home, and I'm able to access the exact same things as I'm able to access from here, sitting at home, without having to go through a dozen different hoops, remember a ton of different host names and ports and so on. So yeah, that's the reason why I searched for Organizer. That's the reason why I did want to make this video, because I've had some questions on this topic. And I do hope that I really helped you in figuring out how you can use Organizer in your own home lab, in your own network, in your own setup. And yeah, so I will leave some links in the description of this video. If not, please remind me to do so. But it's basically just Organizer that you will need, Nginx if you really want to make things a bit more streamlined. And yeah, that's it. So if there's any questions on this, please post them in the comments below. I will reply to you. I think as of now I'm mostly replying to all questions. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I see you again in the next video. Thank you. Bye.